Today in the shop, we are going to use Forscan to configure a solenoid body strategy and ID on a Ford transmission. Shift solenoid strategies and IDs began being used around 2011 with the 6F series of transmissions. The shift solenoid body strategy and ID can be found on a sticker on the transmission, and anytime the valve body or the transmission is replaced, the strategy needs to be reconfigured in the PCM. Replacement valve bodies come with a sticker that needs to be placed on the transmission for the new solenoid body strategy and ID, and what this really is the flow rate of each solenoid in the transmission. Today I'm going to be reconfiguring this on a 6F35 transmission that's getting a new valve body due to metal contamination from a torque converter failure. The procedure is pretty much identical on the later 10-speed family of transmissions. I'm going to be using the Windows-based version of Forscan today for this, and I'm going to start by clicking Connect to Vehicle. And I believe it's got to be the licensed version of Forscan in order to make this change, but I think they still offer a free 2-month license if you just want to try it. And I'm using a Ford VCM2 for the vehicle interface, but if I didn't have access to one of those, I would probably use an OBD Link EX. And hopefully we're just about done connecting to the vehicle here. When you first connect to the vehicle, it finds and talks to every module on every network on the vehicle, so it can take just a minute. I'm going to go ahead and click No, I don't want to save the vehicle profile. The first thing I'm going to do is clear the transmission's adaptive strategy, and we're going to start that by clicking on the service procedure icon on the left. Its little symbol looks like a wrench. And under service procedures, clear transmission adaptive tables is the top choice, and it's already selected, so I'm going to go ahead and click the run button at the bottom of the screen. That's going to give us a pop-up, and I'm going to go ahead and click the OK button that we do want to clear the transmission's adaptive tables. And what the adaptive tables are is the PCM learns how long after it commands the solenoid on or off that it takes for the hydraulic circuits to fill with fluid and the clutch to actually apply. And if we're changing the solenoid body ID or the shift solenoid strategy, obviously we've changed the valve body or the transmission, and it's going to need to relearn these times. And it doesn't matter if you do this before or after the shift solenoid strategy update, but it just needs to be done. We have a service procedure completed successfully message, so I'm going to go ahead and click on the configuration and programming icon on the left. And the second item down in the menu that's going to open up is transmission characterization update. With that highlighted, I'm going to go ahead and click the run button at the bottom of the screen. That's going to give us another pop-up that explains a little bit about the solenoid body ID and strategy, and I'm going to go ahead and click the OK button at the bottom of that. And that's going to give us another pop-up that's going to display the current solenoid body strategy and ID. You can see here that the solenoid strategy and the body ID both match the numbers on the original tag on the transmission. We have update by solenoid strategy number highlighted, and I'm going to go ahead and click the OK button at the bottom of that pop-up. And that's going to give us another pop-up that's going to display our current solenoid strategy number and give us a text box to enter the new strategy. And we're just going to enter the solenoid strategy number that came on the sticker with our new solenoid body. Once we've got that entered, we'll double check and make sure the two match, and then we're going to go ahead and click the OK button. And unless you have downloaded the file ahead of time, you're going to get a pop-up that says file not found, would you like to download it? You will need an internet connection on your laptop for this part, and I'm going to go ahead and click the yes button, and it's going to download the solenoid body strategy from Ford server. If everything downloads and works properly, we should get a pop-up that says blocks program successfully. And when we click the OK button, it should bring us back to our pop-up that shows us what the current solenoid body strategy and ID are. I'm going to compare the solenoid strategy number with the sticker that came with our new solenoid body one more time just to make sure they match. And if you look closely, you'll notice at the same time it downloaded the solenoid strategy, it also downloaded the matching solenoid body ID. With both of those matching our sticker, I'm going to go ahead and highlight exit, and then I'm going to click the OK button. Next, I'm going to go ahead and click the DTC icon on the upper left. We still have a couple of codes in the PCM from when the transmission was failing, and we're going to go ahead and get rid of those. I'm going to go ahead and click the Clear All DTC button at the bottom of the screen. I'll click the Yes button on the pop-up. And when it prompts us, we'll cycle the key off and on and click the OK button. So at this point, the only thing left to do is to relearn the adaptive tables, and that is basically accomplished by slowly accelerating from a stop into high gear and then slowly decelerating all the way to a stop again. And you want to do this 7 or 8 times for it to relearn these values. If you found this helpful or interesting, please click the like button down below. I got a lot more great stuff coming up, so please subscribe. And as always, have a great week.